Hello, I recently made a fire stove model. I want to show you how I handle a couple of things starting with the flames. Show you how I use drivers and constraint to make it look like they are moving in different directions, but also how they are turning off with a couple of controllers. Let's start creating a couple of bones. I already had some on the armature, so I'm going to match their position for those new ones and rename them. You can use the shortcut GA to create bones and reposition the 3D cursor to move them around with the snap menu. And don't forget to rename them using F2 to edit their actual name in edit mode or pose mode. Now it's time to apply some constraints. In pose mode, we can see that by moving our target bone, nothing happens. Let's apply the stretch to constraint to our flame bone. In that way, the head of the bone is going to constantly follow and point to the target. Now we need to make our target move with a main controller so you don't have to move all the planes individually, and for that we are going to use drivers. Starting with the location X from our target bone, I am going to use the add driver option to set the driver manually. In the new panel that opens, we need to define from where the input is coming from. In this case, the location X in local space from our flames controller. What this does is replicate the location X from one bone to another. For the rest of the locations, I'm just going to copy and paste the already set drivers from the other targets. Now something I would like to do is make this movement 10 times slower than the main controller one. And for that, we need to edit the S-curve in the driver editors. This curve right now represents a one-to-one translation of the location. What I am going to do is tell the curve that instead of 1 is equal to 1, now 1 is going to be equal to 0.1. And you must do this for each channel location. Our planes are moving slower now, but we also need to make them move in different directions instead of just having exactly the same movement. For that, we need to return to our driver's curve and apply some noise modifier. The noise modifier is going to apply some randomness to the actual curve, and you are going to be able to visualize that now our values are not going to be linear. Once again, you must apply this to each channel. Fortunately, you can just copy and paste modifiers to one curve to another, and now you can see the movement has some variation compared to original. For the rest of the target, you can also paste the modifier, but you must update the face value to change the seed of the noise effect. If you don't, each target is going to have random movement in the same directions. And that is all for creating random flames movements. Now, let's take a look at how to make them turn on and off. I'm going to duplicate one of the bones to create a new controller in edit mode and change its position. For this bone, I'm going to lock almost all the transform values and make it only possible to rotate in Z axis. Also, I'm going to turn off now the stretch to constraint, saying it blocks the scale of the bones, something that we need to work with right now. Back to the art driver option. In the transform, we are going to set it so the X scale can be controlled with the Z rotation in local space. The idea is to scale the bone from 0 to 1, but the controller rotates from 0 to 180 degrees. With rotation values, the driver sees radian system of degrees. In order to get 180 degrees value, we must use pi, for example. In this case, pi value is going to be a scale 1. And we also need to clamp the curve value so the result cannot be less than 0 or bigger than 1.
Now X scale is changing when we rotate the controller. For the rest of the channels and bones, we just need to duplicate this driver.
Back to the stretch 2 constraint, we just need to apply this same driver to the influence value. A last detail I would like to apply is add the limit rotation constraint to the controller, so the value cannot be less than 0 or bigger than 180 degrees.
And after I copied these scale drivers to the rest of the bones, we basically have all the logic I used to create the flames in the model.
Now, let's quick add some flames model to it. After I magically bring this model from another file, I'm going to duplicate it and join all the meshes. Now, selecting my model first and selecting the armature class, I am going to use Ctrl-P to open the parenting menu and select with entity groups. This creates the armature modifier in the object and adds new entity groups for each bone. This is why naming the bones is important. Now, we just need to assign each flame to the corresponding vertex group. That's it, the flames are ready. For a little organization, I'm just going to move the bones that I don't really need to another layer, leaving only the controllers to play with. I hope you like this, my first actual tutorial. If you are interested, there is some free Blender files with mechanism breaks, including this one on the description. See you later!